Okay, this is Mr. Jewel for SJB Jog Vlogs coming at you from the Lava Center. We've just watched a lovely 12-minute documentary on how volcanoes have formed and the latest eruptions across Iceland. And we are now in the interactive exhibition part of the Lava Center, having a go at all the different things they have here for us. We'll take you along as well, show you what's what. See you in a bit. Mr. Jewel's gonna touch the lava. No, it's fine. All right, it's Mr. Jewel, day two. No, it's not, it's day three here at Iceland. We are currently walking our way towards Seljalandsfoss. Massive waterfall made from glacial water that comes from Eyjafjallajökull volcano. We are also going to go and find the other secret waterfall as well. And all is going to be good. Alright geographers, here we are at Seljalandsfoss. You can now see the waterfall, you can see Mr. Jewel, all is good. You can see Miss Clay slipping on the ice behind me as well. Geographers, what do we think of Seljalandsfoss? It's pretty good. Lovely, lovely. Right, here we are, Seljalandsfoss, give us a wave. There's everybody else as well. Whoa. Looking decent. It's a beautiful waterfall. In a second, we're going to make our way over to this waterfall in this direction. Oh, look, there's Miss Clay as well. Plenty of other waterfalls. According to our information, this used to be on the coastline. So this cave behind the waterfall was eroded by the sea. Oh, we got that on camera. Who was that? Millions of years ago, this was part of the coast and this cave eroded by the sea. JB Jog Vlogs, we made it into the secret waterfall. It's massive and I'm getting soaking wet, but it was worth it. We are at Reynisfjara, the black sand beach. Behind me we've got the basaltic columns and the famous black sand. Lots of coastal landforms here at Reynisfjara. Just behind me there, where is it? There is a little stack of rock. Of course, if I turn around this way, in the far distance, you can't see it, but there's some caves, arches, stacks and stumps galore. Right, I'm going to take you over to the basaltic columns to take a closer look. All right, what's up, geographers? We are at Solheimajökull Glacier. Now, it's a bumpy road. We're walking across quite thick snow. In front of me, you can see the glacier's snout. We've been trekking for about 5-10 minutes or so. Probably got another 5-10 minutes to go to get to the snout. Unfortunately, I haven't brought my gimbal with me this year on our field trip, so the footage is going to have to be a little shaky. I'll try my best not to fall over and get that on camera, because I've already fallen over once on this trip. If you haven't seen that, go back, take a look at yesterday's video when I completely stacked it at Giza. As you can see ahead of me, the glacier itself is a very light blue in colour, and we're going to do our very best to touch the front of it. See you there. Okay, so as you can see right in front of me here, we got some very blue ice. Very, very blue indeed. Kind of like a big chunk of the glacier that's broken off from the centre of it, which is all the way over there. Of course, it's so hard and so cold that that little section remains. Okay, so after about 20 minutes of walking or so, we are literally within touching distance of the glacier's snout. Now, the snout is a geographical term for the front of a glacier. Any rocks and boulders that are littered around the landscape are known as glacial moraine. Those of you that have been studying glaciers at SJB will know that a glacier has a couple of erosion processes. Things like abrasion and plucking. So a lot of the rocks and boulders are plucked out the side of mountains and valley sides as the glacier freezes around them. They then take those rocks down the slopes and deposit them at the snout, which is called glacial moraine. So here we go. This is the front of the glacier, Solheimajökull. As you can see, very blue, very tall, pretty good stuff. Give us a wave. You're on jog vlogs. So these five are the first to make it to the snout of the glacier. The famous five explorers. So we're done with visiting Solheimajökull. We are now making our way back towards the bus, ready for our final stop of the day, which is Skógafoss waterfall. That one which I nearly died at 2 years ago. We're going back for round two. See you there. All right, it's Mr. Joe for SJB Jog Vlogs. We have arrived at Skógafoss. And we are making our way up the side of the mountain to the viewing platform on the top. I'd say we're nearly halfway up. I'm out of breath. I'm getting old. I'm 30 next month. There you go, I nearly tripped over again. Same spot as last time. Right, we've got some geographers with us. Geographers below us. See you at the top. Here come the geographers. Give us a wave. It's a long way up. Alright, we have arrived at the base of Skógafoss waterfall. If I turn around right about now, this is what we are currently looking at. Absolutely amazing. We're about as close to the base as it's safe to get right now. It's cold. We're being attacked by some waterfall spray. But it's epicness.
We'll be right back.